added grief as a local woman tries to put a plaque on her veteran's grave.
I think my husband deserves to be honored.
Thanks for choosing Eyewitness News 5 at 6. I'm Tyler Suters.
And I'm Tierney Cook. In tonight for Jessica Shambach, the Metro widow tried to put a veteran's plaque at her husband's gravesite, but the cemetery changed its rules and refused to place the stone. Well, this morning she called 5 on your side, hoping to stop it from happening to you.
He would want it. I know he would. I mean, we have him bedroom in there. All of his ships, his picture, his, you know, when he got out of the Navy.
Jimmy McCabe spent 20 years in the Navy and 50 with his wife, Betty. In January, he died from prostate and bladder cancer. 8 months later, Betty is fighting with Jimmy's cemetery, West Haven, in Moore.
They couldn't install it. You know, they would just refund my money. And I said, I don't want the money. I said, my husband deserves to have this put on his grave.
Betty paid more than $500 to install a veteran's plaque. 8 months later, it's still not there.
You go to the cemetery and see all around my husband's.
Within a few feet of Jimmy's gravesite, you'll find at least 3. Last week, Rest Haven said a new rule would not allow them to add the plaque with the one already there. Well, halfway through our interview.
Hello? Yes. Yes. Because I think my husband deserves to be honored.
And after a few seconds, I got to talk with Rest Haven.
Is there any way I could come by and talk to you? Or she said that there was some kind of new rule that was in place, but thankfully you guys are going to see past it. Is this a rule that everybody will run into that has to go through Rest Haven?
I got no explanation of this new rule or why Betty had been denied. But 5 on your side got results. Rest Haven will add the plaque to Jimmy's gravesite.
All right. That's all I want.
And she's going to get that. Betty was told the plaque would be in place by Monday. She says she's going to stop by next week to make sure that it's there.
All right, one problem solved, though. Tierney, any other Oklahomans that you know of complaining about similar problems at Rest Haven?
Well, I called the Better Business Bureau this afternoon. Rest Haven has been in business since 1945. They've had 2 complaints filed against them in the last 3 years. One of those complaints, this very same one about the veteran's plaque, that one was resolved just like this one.
All right, 2 for 2. That's good news. All right, great, Tierney.